In this video, we're going to talk about how to plot a curve when you're given the equation in polar coordinates. In particular, we're going to look at the curve r equals 2 cosine theta, and we wonder, hey, what does that curve look like? And now you might be tempted to say, oh, I know what cosine theta looks like. But that's a plot of r versus theta. That's really Cartesian coordinates where you just happen to call the x-axis theta and the y-axis r. No, we want something where theta is the angle and r is the distance. And so this plot is just flat out wrong. Instead, we're going to come up with several methods of plotting the polar plot. One method is to plot the Cartesian plot, graph r versus theta like I just did. But then on a separate sheet of paper, see what that means in terms of the plots. And we're going to think of this as a radar screen. Theta tells you what direction the radar is looking. R is how far away the storm is. Another is to use parameterized curves. You know what R is as a function of theta, but you also know that X is R cosine theta. So that gives you X as a function of theta, and likewise you can get Y as a function of theta. Put them together and you have your position as a function of theta. And if you want, you can call the parameter t instead of theta. It doesn't really matter. You've got yourself a whole parameterization for the curve. And then you can use everything we know about parameterized curves to understand polar curves. And the last method is we can play with the formula sometimes. This doesn't always work. We can sometimes play with the formula to put everything back in Cartesian coordinates, and then we just recognize what everything is saying in Cartesian coordinates. So, let's start with the radar plot. Now we know what r equals 2 cosine theta looks like as a function of r versus theta. It starts off at 2, and then by the time theta is pi over 2, it's 0. And then by the time theta is pi, it's down to negative 2, 0, plus 2. Great. So now what we do is we look at our region, but now this is r and this is theta. And we say, okay, for different values of theta, how far out are we? And we'll start at theta equals 0. When theta equals 0, r is 2. So going in the zero direction, we go two steps out in the zero direction. And then we might want to ask, well, how about when theta is pi over 4? Well, twice cosine of pi over 4 is the square root of 2. So we go the square root of 2 steps out in a 45-degree direction. When theta is pi over 2, r is 0. So by now we're going a distance 0. So here we're 2 away. Here we're root 2 away, and as our direction becomes closer and closer and closer to pi over 2, our distance gets less and less and less and less until we hit r equals 0, that's to say back at the origin, when theta equals pi over 2. And then something funny happens. What happens as we continue going in this direction, increasing theta from pi over 2 all the way to pi? Well, between pi over 2 and pi, theta is negative, r is negative. So we want to go, for example, when in this direction, we want to go a distance minus the square root of 2. Well, that's the same thing as going a distance the square root of 2 back the other way. And when we get to pi, that's pointing this way, we want to go a distance negative 2 to the left. Oh, well, that's the same thing as going 2 to the right. So by the time we've reached pi, we've come back to where we started. Only we're no longer thinking of this as theta equals 0, r equals 2. We're thinking of this as theta equals pi, r equals negative 2. And then you can check that if you continue past pi, r gets, you know, that's the third quadrant, r gets less and less negative, until by the time you hit 3 pi over 2, you're back to 0. And then for the fourth quadrant, r is positive again. So actually, as theta goes from theta to 2 pi, you trace this loop twice. So that's the radar plot. Now, a second method is to use a parameterization. So we're given r as a function of theta. And if you want to use call your parameter t, that's okay. In which case, theta is t, and r is f of t, which in our case is 2 cosine of theta, which is 2 cosine of t. And then x is always r cosine theta. So that's 2 cosine of t times cosine of theta. Well, that's 2 cosine squared of t. And you might remember a trig identity that says that that's 1 plus the cosine of 2t. And r is, y is r sine theta. So that's 2 cosine theta times sine theta. So 2 sine theta cosine theta. So that's 2 sine of t cosine of t. And that's the sine of 2t. And so what we realize is that if x was cosine of 2t and y was sine of 2t, that would just be going in a circle with double speed. X is 1 plus that, so we're going in a circle starting at one step to the right, and we just go around in a circle, cosine and sine, plus 1. This plus 1 means that the center of the circle is at 1, 0. And we go around twice as fast as you might think. And the last way to plot this curve is with some algebra and trigonometry. We know that r is 2 cosine theta, and we want to express everything in terms of x and y. And the tricks we have is that x is r cosine theta, and y is r sine theta, and that x squared plus y squared is r squared. Now, we don't have an r cosine theta, and we don't have an r squared, but if we just multiply both sides of the equation by r, then we do. R squared is 2r cosine theta. And then we say, oh, r squared is x squared plus y squared, and r cosine theta is x. And there you go. You've got an equation in terms of x and y. You've got it in Cartesian coordinates. Then we manipulate it a little bit. We subtract 2x from both sides. And then I'm going to add 1 to both sides. And you notice that x squared minus 2x plus 1 is x minus 1 squared. So x minus 1 squared plus y squared equals 1. And we recognize that this is exactly a circle of radius 1 centered at the point 1, 0, which is exactly what we got from the parameterization and is exactly what we got from the radar method.